That's the fifth grade band. It's their first time ever playing an instrument. But I just want to thank you for being here for them. They've been so nervous for like the last 3 months, maybe. So today was really crazy and lots of questions and everything. First concert for them. It might be the first concert for you as well. But we're happy to be here. The fifth grade band meets one time a week as a whole. Well, this band meets as two half a band. And then they also meet together in their little sections, like the flute section meets on Monday, percussion meets on Friday. So they're doing a good job just learning how to put things together. We learn to sit with good posture. We learn to breathe. We learn the first five notes and note values. And when we put those note values together, we learn rhythms. We also learn how to play together and get along as well as how to listen to each other. That's a real hard thing when you're trying to learn something that's so you right now and then to listen to everybody else too and stay together. That's a big thing. So we go from excuses of, it is too hard. I can't reach the floor. My mouthpiece is stuck. I can't practice. It sounds better when I play it in my head. Two, I did it. I am taller than Mrs. Smith now. What do I do next? I will try. Do you need help? And I did it. The last three words, and the first three of the second group, is why I love teaching fifth grade band. They did it. So our next songs are from our book, and so I hope you enjoy them. We'll just go straight through them. Hope you enjoy.
You can tell they did. I like their smiles at the end, right? Okay. Crusader smile. You guys ready? Don't forget the word.
Thank you.
rhythms going on at the same time. So I'm trying to give them some time to get all the percussion back over, so I'm stalling a little bit. But they really learn to play together and count as their part is different. They still complain that it's too hard, but they're learning the process of making music. And that's one of the things that we really want to install in all of our music, choir included, is how to make music together for you. Our first song is Like the Grove, and our second song is Cool Blue.
Thank you.
Okay, so those first two songs were, they had to learn contrasting styles. First one was nice and smooth. We learned a new word called legato. And the second one was in a cool blues jazzy style. So we learned a little bit about chord building and just kind of playing in a different style. Whereas the first one was kind of slow and sweet, and the second one was more jazzy and cool. They like the cool jazzy one, by the way. Our next song is called Snooze Alarm, and it took them a while to convince that they could play this. As a lot of different county, especially back in the percussion, we're playing a bird whistle. You want to hold up the bird whistle? We didn't even know what a bird whistle was before, but I ordered it, and there it is. We have a slapstick, a tambourine, and timpani, our xylophone, and then in addition to all of the other instruments. But within that one song, they learned articulation, which is how we play a piece. We learned things like accents and staccato, playing short, and forte, which is loud, and piano, which is very soft. So see if you can listen for some of those things and snooze along. Getting them here. We had all times from this morning was the concert to tomorrow's the concert, and I'm amazed that they all made it here, and thank you for getting them here. So I'm going to pass it on to the 7th and 8th grade now.
Between there and here. So this is our 7th and 8th grade band. They rehearse 3 times a week. and they spend about 45 minutes three times a week with me. And so they meet in smaller sections and then full band. So I see woodwinds, I see brass and percussion, I see the full band all together once a week, and then I see all of the winds all together and then percussion by themselves. So we work really hard on learning how to play together. So what you just saw between the fifth and sixth grade, fifth grade, they were all playing the same notes for the most part. They're learning how to play together. They're also in the process of learning how to speak a new language. Everything that they're doing, they are speaking and they are reading a new language, a language that they have not spoken and that they have not read in before. In addition to that, they are bringing a piece of metal and plastic and wood to life. They're breathing air into these instruments, they're striking these instruments, and they're turning it into a sound that humans have the innate ability to understand and to enjoy. And we are very fortunate that when we hear music, for most people, it evokes emotion. Now, when you know, when we're playing in fifth grade band and we're playing hot cross buns, we're like, oh, that's cute, you know, hot cross buns. All right, it's, you know, it's they're learning to speak a new language. And so we all can appreciate that for the hard work that they're putting in and the new things that they're learning. Sixth grade, they continue to learn how to speak that language. It takes years for children to learn how to speak. It takes years for children, for people, for humans to learn how to do something like this, to learn how to speak this language and how to use these instruments that we all play. So now they're in seventh and eighth grade and we are really trying to dig into the whole music part of it, the emotion part of it, learning how to produce really good tones and to play really well together and to learn how to listen to each other and to cooperate and to work together. And they still say every day, this is too hard. It is. It's very, very hard. I tell my students very frequently, if this were easy, everybody would do it. This is not easy. Nothing about what we're doing here is easy. And they come every day and they give their best effort, and that's all I ask of them, is their best effort. And they do it every single day. And we're playing some music tonight that is more difficult than I have asked the seventh and eighth graders to play, particularly here in the most recent years, and they have certainly risen to that occasion, so I'm very excited to share this music with you. So I think we are all set. Fantastic. So the first two pieces we are going to play, we are playing Triton Fanfare, and then we are going to perform Handclap, which is actually a band arrangement of a pop song, so you'll probably recognize our second piece, Handclap. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
percussionists are learning how to do is tune timpani by themselves, so it takes just a few moments because they're still learning, so if you'll bear with us for just a moment. So our final piece this evening is called Afterburn. When I pass this piece of music out, many of my students, many of the seventh and eighth graders looked at me like I had three heads and I was crazy, because it is the first piece of music that they have played that requires two pages instead of just one. And that was a little bit of a mind-blowing experience when I passed it out, but we found out very quickly that we were very much capable of playing this music. It is difficult, actually. Interestingly enough, I'm going to share this with you. This particular piece of music, the year would have been 2021, so the year after the pandemic, well, not after, we were still in the middle of the pandemic, but the year after everything had gotten shut down, we came back to school, band had been split up into three different periods, it was a crazy year, we weren't able to get a whole lot done, but at the end of the year, we did manage to pull together and put together a banquet slash band concert for the end of the year. That was the 2020-21 school year. And this piece of music that they are playing was first performed at that banquet slash band concert by the high school band. So again, it was kind of a crazy year. We hadn't been able to work together very much. So this was one of the pieces of music that I purchased for the high school band to perform. I came across it in my library and I thought to myself, these junior high kids need a challenge. And I think this is the right one. Also, it's written by Randall Standridge, and I've been on a Randall Standridge kick for a few years. My high school kids will agree. We play something by Randall Standridge almost every concert. We have for a few years. So it's a bit of an issue for me. So anyway, so we are going to play this piece of music again. It's our first two-pager. Our timpani player back there, Natalie, she's playing, and this requires all four timpani drums, which is a new experience for her. There's just lots and lots of things going on. This is the first time that our woodwind players have kind of experienced the whole fingers flying thing, going fast and having to move really quickly. It's been an experience, but they're doing a great job with it. So here it goes, Afterburn by Randall Standridge.
Thank you. disappointed.
Means a little more talking for me, and I do apologize for that. However, I have some really cool things to share. And most of you are probably aware, I don't know, we blew it up all over social media the entire time we were there. We just got back, this group over here, every single one of them, got back from Florida just a few weeks ago. We went to Orlando, Florida, and we enjoyed a couple days at Disney, and we enjoyed a couple days at Universal Studios. And while we were at Universal Studios, we had the honor and privilege of performing on stage at Universal City Walk, which is this huge kind of town center area that connects together the two big Universal Studio parks. So we were able to perform on stage there. It's a really cool stage. It was out over top of like a big lagoon water, and we went up there and we performed. We worked on for 6 weeks. We worked on four pieces of music, and we were able to successfully and quite handily actually perform those pieces in front of an audience of people from all over the United States and the world, honestly. Interestingly enough, there was a couple in that crowd from Lisbon. So we ran into some people that we, you know, that were pretty close to home, but, and we brought along our own posse too. We had probably at least a good 15, maybe pushing 20 people that were there with us that were just there. They decided to vacation at the same time we did so that they could see our concert and spend some time with us while we were there. So it was easily one of the best Disney trips. I've done 7 or 8 Disney trips now as a school trip or band trip, and this was easily one of the best ones I've ever had. It was just, we had fun, it was pretty relaxing, we had a great performance, we enjoyed our time in the parks, it was just an awesome time. So I count myself very lucky that I had this group of students to go with me, because I didn't have to worry about too much while we were there. I knew that they would represent us well and perform well and have a good time, and they certainly did. So thank you to those of you who helped us get there. It was not an easy feat. We fundraised and we fundraised and we fundraised. And we had donations come in from all over the place. We had lots and lots of help getting us there. And because of all of that help, we were able to get every single high school band student on that bus and into Orlando, Florida. And I am eternally grateful for that. So thank you to the community for supporting us through that and for helping us get there. It was a wonderful trip. We had a wonderful experience, and I'm so very grateful that so many people helped us with that. So thank you very much. We're having a meeting of the minds back in the percussion section. Of all of the things to have to move, it's always percussion. We have to share percussion, and there's just so much. There's so much percussion. So many instruments. Okay, so we are going to perform this evening two pieces. Like I said, we performed four. We are going to perform two pieces for you this evening that we performed in Orlando, Florida. We're going to perform Kentucky 1800 by Clare, Grundman, which is a staple in wind band music. And then we are also going to perform Salvation is Created, another staple in wind band literature. So we are going to perform both of those pieces for you, and then we will finish up our concert. Before we finish up, we're going to do a little introduction of some of our seniors, and we're going to talk about a few things before we do that. But we're going to go ahead and get started with Kentucky 1800. We're going to play a scale first because we have a play for a few minutes here, so we're going to warm up for just a hot second. One moment, please.
B-flat concert, whole notes, listen, blend, tune if you can. Here we go. 1, 2, ready.
Thank you.
Ready, half notes. About what you want it to sound like. Imagine what you want it to sound like. Here we go.
A lot happens between there and here. A lot. high school band. I'm so fortunate with high school band. I get a whole hour with them 5 days a week. And it is the best hour of my day, I swear. We get so much done, and we can play so much music, and we work on so many things. So the amount of stuff that we're able to do is pretty incredible, and what's the best about it is that we are able to get most of what we need done during the school day. And that includes during marching band. You know, marching band takes even more work, because in addition to doing all that that they just did, of course we send them out into the middle of a football field and tell them to run around in an organized fashion. Memorize where the blade of grass is that you're supposed to stand. So it's really quite a thing. It's really quite a thing that we do. And so a lot happens to get from there to here, and a lot of what happens is incredibly hard work on their part, on their part. Like I said, none of this is easy, and as they progress through all of this from fifth grade all the way through to, there's, I believe, eight seniors sitting behind me here, but this is their eighth Music in Our Schools concert. They have put in hours and hours of work and literal blood, sweat, and tears to be able to do what it is that they do, and it's really incredible, and I'm very grateful that they are willing to share that time with me and to work as hard as they do, because I can stand up here and wave my arms until I fall over if they don't work at it, if they don't put the effort in, and they don't, you know, put all of the time and energy into it, then it's all for naught. And it's definitely all for a lot of really good with this group. So I'm very fortunate to have such wonderful students to work with. That goes for you guys too. You're pretty awesome. All right, so our next piece is Salvation is Created. I'm just gonna let this piece speak for itself.
Thank you.
We're almost done. We're almost there. But I want to introduce a few people to you before we do that. First and foremost, like I said, there are eight seniors sitting in this band right now. Like I said, this is for all of them. Their eighth music in our school's concert. So I would be remiss if I did not introduce them to you because they are fantastic individuals. I have been so fortunate to get to know them so well over the past 8 years, and I'm very excited to see where all of them go and what they do, and I really hope that they don't forget about us and they come visit and check in with me every once in a while because I'm going to miss them all dearly. Even you guys back there. Yeah, I see you. All right, so up first we have Melody in our clarinet section. Melody Wright. In our trumpet section we have Charles Bryson. Right next to him in the French horn section we have Keely Smith, Mrs. Smith's daughter. They are some of the most involved individuals that we have in our school district. They do more than just, they don't sleep. Some of them don't, I swear, because they have incredible grades. They take college classes. They're in three sports throughout the school year. They do so many things, and it's really quite incredible. So I'm going to ask some people to stand, and after you stand, I'm going to go ahead and have you sit. And we're going to go through this. Some of this will involve some of our junior high students. Some of it is specific just to our high school band. But I want to show you just a little bit of what these kids do outside of the band room. So, 7 through 12, any of you that play a fall sport at East Liverpool Junior Senior High School, would you please stand? Cross-country, soccer, what else?
Golf.
Oh yeah, that thing my husband coaches, golf. Forgot about that one. Yeah, so that would be those sports. All right, fall sports, you may be seated. Some of these people are about to get a real workout. Winter sports, would you please stand? Swimming, basketball, wrestling. Bowling, that's great. Bowling. Oh, yeah, like half the bowling team. Oh, yeah. Okay, bowling. All right. Go ahead and have a seat. And spring sports, would you please stand as you recognize our spring sports people? All right, and you may have a seat. All right, now some of this is going to be a little incredibly intelligent individuals sitting on this floor. So those of you that are in NHS, National Honor Society, or National Technical Honor Society, would you please stand? To get a few more people involved in that, we have a rather large percentage of the academic team in band right now, and they are, y'all have been kicking butt, right? Academic team, would you guys stand up? All right, and then finally, those of you that are enrolled in College Credit Plus, how many of you would that involve? I guess, there we go. So these are students that are currently taking college credit classes. I was actually just talking to Mr. Ulrich today. By the time he graduates from high school, he's going to almost have a bachelor's degree. He is whizzing through some of those college classes, so we are incredibly proud of them and their at how much they excel in their academics. All right, you may have a seat. As I'm sure you are all well aware, this is a comprehensive high school, and we offer an incredible number of career tech programs. A very large portion of my high school band is involved in career tech. So those of you that are currently enrolled in a career tech program, would you please stand? And you may be seated. And finally, last but not least, the thing that most of these students are basically living, eating, and breathing right now, those of you, this includes some junior high students as well, those of you that are involved in theater, please stand. By the way, you should most definitely come see SpongeBob SquarePants here in just a couple of weeks. You may be seated. So, like I said, incredible involvement from these students, and I'm sure you noticed the workout that a few of them got because they stood up and sat down almost everything, every single time I said something and asked a new group of people to stand up. They're involved. Some of them are dual sport and triple sport athletes. They don't take a break, and they keep going, and it is incredible. I'm just so very proud of all of them and the fact that they are so committed to our school district and to not just being good leaders here in our band, but across our entire school. They are truly some of the best leaders that we have in our school district, and I'm very fortunate that they share their abilities with me as well, so thank you. All right, and I believe that is everything that I wanted to mention this evening, so without further ado, yet another Randall Standridge piece. This we learned in 3 weeks. We came back from Florida, and I was like, we need to find something else to do. Let's learn this piece of music. Interestingly enough, it's the most difficult piece of music that we are playing, and we learned it in only 3 weeks, so it's been a bit of a race, but we got there. So this is Ruckus, Randall Standridge.
To will your salivary glands to keep up for like the next 3 minutes and then it's over, okay? Don't rush. Keep it cool, okay? Imagine Mr. Kaiser and Mr. Morris prowling around the gym like they were this afternoon. Ready?
joining us for our music in our schools concert. Like I said, SpongeBob SquarePants here in a couple of weeks, great musical, and the high school band's going to be putting on a rock concert in May, so stay tuned for that rock concert. All right, thank you very much. Have a wonderful evening.